my child, I thought that he had at least a glass of milk. Kukka kukka, I used to say no. Brush your teeth before going to bed also. There are certain things which you need to insist. You have to eat vegetables. Tell me how you like it. We cannot fry the vegetables, it's like a meal. So certain things we need to set an example and make sure they get it. Though I was a working mom, I felt I spent quality time with my child than quantity time. Only the mothers. So please learn, you can live in this society today where a mother is working at the same time raising the child. And many a times it's the maid who's taking care of the kid or the creche who's taking care of the kid. So what you pack, that's number one. If you run behind fat diets, they cannot be lifelong. I don't want to mention, there are people who want to lose weight for an event. They run behind a fat diet, they lose weight. They want to put on for another event, they put on. You need to start a diet which will avoid all the nutrient deficiencies, keep up your health going, and you should be able to maintain it for a long time. If somebody says, remove carb from your diet, just imagine removing your carb. How many days can you sustain? So it has to be a sustainable, healthy diet.
Okay, when it comes to carbohydrates, choosing the right carb is very, very important, okay? We know there are two types of carbs. One is simple, another one is complex, okay? So when you are choosing the refined products to be avoided to the maximum, wherever possible, you can add whole grain cereals rather than going for the polished ones. As ma'am said, sustainability is very, very important. How far you can continue the diet, that is most important. It is not that losing, you follow any diet for a month, you lose weight and then you can go back to a normal diet. No, never. We don't say like that at all. So choosing and eating the right food is very, very important when it comes to maintaining or leading a quality life. That is what we are trying to educate our clients whoever walks into our clinic. Ma'am, is that right?
And you know, I think diets and fat diets and keto is something we can go on and on, ma'am. And I think most women would be interested in knowing about that as well. But here today we are here to discuss about fortification and about Nu-Shakti and, you know, brands like Nu-Shakti and why, you know, you should be using them more often in your food. Now, we also have an influencer mom here, Arul, and I also have an 8-year-old daughter, so I can understand how tough it is to feed, you know, a kid, especially a kid who has a mind of his own. So my child is now at that state that yeh nahi khana, woh nahi khana. So Arul, what's your experience? Is your child a fuzzy eater? How do you manage?
So when we started off, he was perfectly fine. He used to eat whatever I gave him. But slowly as he's growing up now, he's like almost two. I see that he has his preferences. There are some foods that he completely avoids. Again, that is worrying to me because then those nutrients are completely left out. So dealing with a fuzzy eater as they grow up is of course a challenge. So how can we ensure that, you know, we give them the whole spectrum of that food when they are fuzzy in the first place?
Okay. It is tough. As the child grows, one, there will be a lot of distractions. Second, family influence. Somebody might say, I don't like curd. The baby listens to it. He loves to repeat, he loves to enact. So number one is the family's behavior. That's very, very important. If we say, oh yuck, finished. Next time the baby looks at it, he is going to enact the same. So our way of dressing, walking, talking, tone, everything matters. Like that, these habits are early, habits which they pick up very fast. So the healthy meal, the whole family has to follow. Yes, they are very distracted. The quantity of eating is too less. Since we are going on talking about fortification, we all might think it's something very new, very fashionable, which didn't happen for a long time. Actually, it's a very, very old theory. Imagine our salt. Can you imagine a salt which is not iodized? Why did they iodize the salt? we had to get enough iodine in our diet. And our normal salt consumption, see again, fortification, which food? They choose a food which is widely used by the population. And then they add the quantity, according to the quantity what we consume. Salt, our normal Indian intake of salt is between 10 and 12 grams. Actually, it's more. We are advocating it to get cut down to 8 grams. So if at all they add iodine, they add in such an amount which our body needs. Same way, any food which they fortify, especially for kids, they don't want to mention companies and brand names. Somebody launched a cereal. They brought it as a fortified cereal. So I was asked to tell why fortification is needed. What I tell is, if this baby is going to eat 3 teaspoons or 4 teaspoons, if we have to enhance the nutrients there, you can't make it. To get the proper amount of nutrients, the baby might need a lot of quantity. Baby is going to eat very less. Give it nutrient dense. See, our ancestors have told us to give dal rice, khichdi or pulp sadam with ghee in it. Why? So their rice, carbohydrate, dal, protein, ghee is the fat. They will say mash some vegetables and give. You would have mashed, made a cup, but how much a baby will eat? Baby will eat only 1/4 of the cup or half the cup. Actually, the remaining goes inside our body, which should not. That's how our mom puts on more weight, but we make it calorie dense, nutrient dense. So when a fortifying product comes, it makes that dish nutrient dense. Even if the baby takes 2 teaspoons, 3 teaspoons, please, when we give a fortified, add a fortified some product to it, it becomes nutrient dense. When kids are fussy, if we have to take care of their growth, I would suggest fortification as a good means to reach the goal.
I would like to add for the fuzzy eating children, how to manage them. Maybe you can educate them about the food groups, the way they can understand. And sitting together and eating as a family meal, that is very, very, very important. And how many of us we do, I don't know. You make the child to sit in front of the television, or you give them the mobile phone and you make the child. You are worried about the quantity, but not about the quality. That's what as dietitians we feel and we have seen. And most of the parents know doing this. If you can correct this and involving the child in preparations, whatever, the best way you can, they will come to know about the value of nutrients and they can understand and they can have it in a healthy way, to lead a healthy life.
I mean, that's such an important point made both by Dr. Pindleshwari and Dr. Hema here. Like, I also see, as a mother, what we do tend to do in our families is bache ko we give the food first, and then we sit together and as a family and we eat and the baby is done earlier. I think that's where fussy eating, is born, that very moment. So you should be eating together, like Dr. Hema said, eating from the same family pot. I mean, it's so important and we've all forgotten about it. Also, Dr. Bhuvneshwari particularly asking you, I mean, so much of information, like I was saying, like koi bolta hai, milk is not good for you, it has some hormones, injected, this is not good for you. This was something that I also came across, but then I met a doctor and she said, see, everything is good or bad, but how do you control it? So when you have products like this, so much of misinformation, where do you think the role of products like Nu-Shakti, what role do they play and how important it is?
Okay, though I would not like to mention the name of the products, I would say I would appreciate such products coming to the market which is affordable, number one. Easy to use. Here, people have to understand why. Why have you brought the technology? I mean, if you really know how it is made, they brought something for rice which looks like rice. As a nutritionist, I asked questions saying, you say it has so many minerals, vitamins. How is the bioavailability? Does it reach the body? Second, there are some vitamins which are heat resistant. So they said, we have made something like rice, which is embedded, the nutrients are, how beautiful it is. Same way for atta, they made some powder which will get assimilated with the atta. Something, see, when we go abroad, you see oil in fortified, you see juices fortified, you can get a cereal mix which is fortified. Why did they do? They did it for a reason. There's a lot of research and development done to bring in such products. But it has to reach especially the mothers. If a mom understands, the whole family understands. The mom is a wife, mom is a daughter-in-law, mom is a daughter. So, you know, you influence the family much more than anybody else. If a mother understands nutrition, the whole family understands it better. So, I feel products like this, beet and oil, beet, sugar, they fortify sugar, they fortify oil, they fortify salt, they fortify cereals. Because these we do use. And juices are drunk by babies. So if they enhance things in the juice also, it's good. But again, as I said, oil, how much oil will a baby take? Whereas when you enhance a cereal, we all of us give some cereal or other. Beet, wheat, atta, or chawal, rice. So thoda sa if you give also, the baby gets that much vitamins and minerals.
That was really insightful. And as Dr. rightly said, the mother is the one who takes, in fact, all decisions, even when it comes to buying what curtains you are buying to your house, what car color you should be buying. I mean, she is the main decision maker, and so are all of you sitting in this room. So to make use of this opportunity and do as much posts, as many posts as you can on social media. And coming back to the topic of discussion today, ma'am, nutrition, fortification, and of course a balanced diet for kids. You know, like Arun was saying that her child is a fussy eater. Now my daughter eats a lot. She's 8 and she has those growth spurts, right? They call it the growth spurts. So she's, someday she'll be like hungry the whole day, you know, like, I mean, I don't know what to feed her, honestly. And sometimes I get worried, you know, I mean, is there something wrong? Is her pet? Like in North, they say some she has got worms, you know, in her stomach. You should do deworming and all that. But I don't know. Then my father is also a veterinary doctor. Vishali's father is a So my father is also a veterinary doctor. He told me it's fine with her. You know, they're growth spurts. So how do you, first of all, understand that your child is not eating enough and your child is not overeating also at the same time? How, as a mother, do you decide that?
First, as I said, bring in the family culture of eating. If you eat cake and tell the kid you're plump, you can't eat cake, which is wrong. Second, what I feel is, please, please give them physical activity time. It's overall development which is needed. It's not only marks which will take you somewhere. I can tell you, I interview 1,000 candidates. Marks takes you somewhere. Beyond that, it is your individual capability to communicate. Your etiquette, mannerism, that matters a lot. There may be somebody who's got 99 out of 100. There may be somebody who's got 80 out of 100. You've reached where you need to reach. You've reached up to the interview. After that is what you're taught regarding your mannerism, language, body language, etiquettes. There are so many things. So let's not make them sit and study and study and study. Do only homework. Please bring in physical activity in a daily routine. You go for a walk, tell Beta, come with a cycle. You cycle, I will walk. You try to match his speed, he tries to match your speed. So then, you know, games need not be only indoor games. Second, there are professional mothers who thinks that she needs to, you know, go to the profession, spend more time, earn more money, buy more gifts. Baby needs your time. That is the best gift. After some time, baby doesn't find time to spend with you. He grows over it. So, and these are forming stages, habit forming. So addictions to TV, addictions to media, addiction to food also happens to me. So if the child is not eating, there should be some reason. It need not be only health reason. It could be even stress. The word of stress really I have not heard when I was a baby or young. We were very carefree. Today for everything baby is stressed. Because the stress is there in the atmosphere. Study stress, school stress, dressing stress, peer stress, be it anything. So you know, mental health also is equally important. So you need to talk, spend time and get the stress out of the child's mind. And if the child is overweight by any chance, there's a lot of body shaming happening.
Yes.
Among the peer groups, they lose confidence. So allow them to do more physical activity, fill their stomach, cut down the calories, unwanted calorie. I would rather say trim the unwanted calorie. Make a good plate. See, if the child likes cake, make a cake, but portion control. What? They can overboard, make it again variety. The kids need variety, they get bored with small things repeated very often. If you say carrot is good for your eye, good for it, everybody don't make carrot, they get bored. So if they love colors, they love dishes, different dishes, what they can eat less, give them in a small cup which looks good. Change the cup, change the mug, change the spoon. It's not very possible. So these are small tips which you can make the child show interest towards food. Him or the child.
Yes. Maybe the texture of the food to be taken into consideration. Texture, the consistency is very, very important. And the temperature of the food. When you serve the food, it should be given in right temperature. And practically, it is not possible for the working mothers. Maybe you can keep this in mind when you work, when you sit and eat together as a family meal, maybe during the holidays, this can be kept in your mind. You can implement this, okay?
Since you said about texture, I would like to say we all love to give the khichdi kinds. Imagine going to school and putting your fingers. They like finger foods. Literally, kids love. You give a roti, you give it as a stuffed roti, they expect it to be rolled, which can be taken and bitten, or the roll should be cut into portions, or something with a fork. Fashion. They love it. Let's talk facts. They like to pick and eat, not messy stuff. Especially when they carry. At home, give them messy stuff. And even if they spill, see, I again don't want to compare Western world. We are copying so many things. Let's copy good stuff.
Yes.
They have a place to eat. They have a chair which can become a writing table, come an eating table. And they put the apron and they allow the baby to spill. They allow the baby to touch, take in the mouth. Let the baby apply all over the face, doesn't matter. Give a discount. Give more so that it can be applied, it can be spilled out. But the baby learns to eat. Baby touches the food, they get connected. Hand-eye coordination, I'm sure as a doctor, you agree. We want them to touch, arrange a toy. Why not food? So, I have seen many mothers, the minute baby eats, either a TV on or an iPad or mobile on. So you want to divert the child and you want it to go like a machine. Don't do that. It may be tough and do not start. If you have done it for your first kid, don't do it for your second kid, at least now.
That is so, useful information coming from like senior nutritionists here, and really so many takeaways for all of us here. And I totally do not believe in any kind of screens, and I never fed my child in front of the television. She used to sit with me and eat, and as you said, I used to give her whatever we were eating at the same table within a plate, and she would be messy and all over the place, but she ate herself and she eats all veggies today. So I think that's something you should be also doing. If you're not doing it for the first child, second child, click hello. And like doctor was saying, we are so cautious and so concerned these days, like parents, like for physical activity, Many moms don't send only to the playground. It's very dirty, hygienic, it's dust all around. Of course, there are health reasons also which should be kept in mind. But not for all kids. If your child is healthy, he should be playing out, in the mud, in the field. Arun, you're an influencer mom here, and I'm getting a couple of questions online.